Hello everyone, I want to welcome you this evening to our program. And to start it off, I'm going to introduce Kirkland Lewis to sing our national anthem.
You ready for the national anthem?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that a flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? Yeah, the
when you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm,
hey everyone, my name is Deontay Francois. I'm one of your three hosts for tonight's program.
Welcome to Farmingdale's Black History Month, hosted by our club, Real Harmony.
Hello everyone, I'm Makai Jones, another one of the hosts for tonight's program. The goal of the Real Harmony Club is to promote ethnic and multicultural awareness and diversity at Farmingdale High School. We meet weekly and host many multicultural events.
Hi everyone, I'm also a host. My name is Josiah Wilkes, and I just want to tell you today that it's very important to highlight the struggles faced by Black Americans. It is also important to face and show the highlights and accomplishments that they have achieved. Black history is American history.
We would like to give thanks to the members of the Board of Education, Central and Building Administration, teachers, staff, parents, and fellow students for joining us tonight. Without further ado, let us introduce the first day.
As Africans were stolen from their homes to be sold as slaves, they were scattered across the world from South and North America to Europe and the Caribbean. Africans brought dance with them to these new locations and in places such as Europe and South America, where slaves were given more freedom to practice their traditions. Their dances merged with the pre-existing dance styles to form new dances. Here to honor traditional African dance are Deja Pruitt, Kiari Johnson, Shaquilla Arthur, Kiera Lambert, Tanya Gomez, and Constance Byatire.
The Black Lives Matter protests were deeply rooted between the civil rights protests back in the 1950s. Two students, Amaya Johnson and Juliet Hutchinson, were inspired by these protests and wrote a poem. Here to share her poem with you guys today is Abiah Johnson.
To the non-believers and seers. What have we done that makes you scorn us so? Is it the tone in our skin? Or the cries in our voice? What more must we do? You hate to see the passion of our people. We've tried the rallies. We've tried the riots. But you've yet to hear us. Must we be louder? You pry us from our culture and emotion and deem it as normal. Tell me, is this normal? What have we done? What more can we offer? What more do you want to hear? Is what all we can say? Have you thought about it? The only word you bring us to is what, as we plead. You stand armed with weapons of justice raised, while we rise with our arms in the air and clenched fists raised. You claim it's for the peace, but there are bodies in our streets. Du Bois, Brown, Floyd, Aubrey Martin, and Reed. You say we're over-exaggerating, but the list goes on. I didn't even do nothing, said Du Bois. Why do you have your guns out? Said Chamberlain. I can't breathe, cried Floyd. Was that not enough? Must we name more? What are you following me for? Said Martin. You claim you felt threatened. But by what? Was it the smile on our face? Or the candy in our hand? We all band together to take this stand. For the lives that can no longer fight. For the pure innocence that once thrived. Your bloodlust grows with every step we take towards equality. But no matter how hard we try, you blind us from the reality we crave. Is this truly humanity?
Hey, how y'all doing? I'm sorry. I just gotta turn the page. Little Rock 9 were a group of 9 black students who desegregated the all-white Little Rock Central High School in 1957, following the Supreme Court's historic Brown versus the Board of Education decision. It was these events that helped the young McCartney to create the song Blackbird. At the Little Rock concert, McCartney introduced Blackbird by telling the audience, way back in the 60s, there was a lot of trouble going on over civil rights, particularly in Little Rock. We would notice this on the news back in England, so it's really an important place for us, because to me, this is where civil rights started. We would see what was going on and sympathize with the people going through these troubles, and it made me want to write a song that if I ever got back to the people going through these troubles, it might just help them a little bit, and that's this next one. Here to perform Blackbird is Jackson Rivera, accompanied by the acoustic guitar by Grace Suzuki.
broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You were only waiting for what's going to arise. But it would seem that the love night, take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You were only waiting for this moment to be free, like birdfly, like birdfly, into light and dark like mine.
Gospel music has been a powerful force in American culture. It has helped slaves escape to freedom, it enriched America's diversity, and it was a supporting backbone in the civil rights movement. It has also paved the way for different genres of music, but most of all, it has empowered people to be more than they could be. The song Wade in the Water is rumored to have some hidden meanings. One such possible rumor is that Harriet Tubman used the song to tell escaping slaves to get off the trail and into the water, to make sure the dogs, slave catchers, couldn't sniff them, sniff their trail out, my apologies. People walking through the water did not leave a scent trail that dogs couldn't find. To read her original poem, Black History, while the spiritual Wade in the Water is playing in the background, please welcome Tanya Velasquez. Also reading are Deja Pruitt and Kiori Johnson.
Black history. What does black history sound like? History sounds like 9 months, like birth of a new life, like a calm whisper over a cradle, sweet melody over a tight beat. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. History sounds like Ella, like jazz, even when we're beaten, black and bruised, backs bent, backs barely breathing. History somehow sounds like the blues, like Harlem, like Duke, like Marcus, like Survival, like the Humes. Like the clicking of a railroad track. It sounds like an old Negro spiritual.
Celebration and safe houses. Sounds like Harriet. Underground to freedom. Where freedom ain't so free. Sounds like 1913 and everything in between. The beats of women marching. We woke with shards on our knuckles and in between our fists. So keep your glass slipper. Women not supposed to do no heavy lifting. We belong in kitchens,
in the house, in the Senate, in the Oval Office.
History sounds like
Michelle, like Ruth, like Amanda, like Shirley.
Sometimes history sounds like a silent moving powerhouse. It sounds like the clipping of Jim Crow's wings.
It sounds like Dr. Martin Luther King, like Booker T. Washington, like the unnoticed heroes we don't care or hear about. She sounds like
Baker, Clark, Bates.
Black women being out of this world. The stay behind chalkboards? These figures are still undercalculated. History sounds like the start of new homes,
new things, new paths, like a fresh crunch.
Sometimes we forget that we are history. Days where we wake up and don't remember the history that built us. Days where black children forget to listen to the music pumping in their veins. History sounds a lot like you.
A beautiful black gifted soul, you.
Stepping has been derived from various African traditions and cultures. The stepping that we're familiar with today is from black fraternities and sororities back in the 1900s. Stepping. Spread across college campuses in America. Latino, Asian, and multicultural fraternities and sororities all picked up on this art form. Here to pay tribute to this art are Steppendalers. They have been coached by Constance Byattire and Emily Fernandez.
Faith Williams and Sylvie Axis were inspired to do a tribute to victims of police brutality and systematic racism. Here are Faith and Sylvie with their presentation.
Hi, my name is Sylvie Axis, and I'm here with Faith Williams. June 2020 was a very eye-opening time for the Black community. The murder of George Floyd sparked the largest civil rights movement in history. People around the world showed solidarity with the Black community here in America, but there were many George Floyds before George Floyd. We are here to pay tribute to the victims of the systematic racism that plagues our country today. Those were 35 seconds of silence for the 35 victims shown today. These were just 35 out of the hundreds of black people killed because of their skin color. We hope that one day we will not have to march and protest. We hope that we can exist without worrying about our rights being violated. And we hope that we won't have to add yet another hashtag to our social media accounts.
Say their names.
In Reuben Jackson's poem entitled For Trayvon Martin, he imagines himself as the boy's guardian angel leading him home and out of harm's way that fateful night 10 years ago. Jackson once said, "When I was growing up, my male friends and I would walk each other home from parties, the corner store, what have you. I wanted that same love and protection for Trayvon. Perhaps he would have made it home that night. Here to read Jackson's poem is Makai Jones.
Instead of sleeping, I woke with him from the store. No Skittles, thank you. We do not talk much. Sneakers crossing the courtyard, humid southern night. We shake hands and hug, ancient, stoic tenderness. I nod to the moon. I'm so old school. I hang to the latch clicks like an unloaded gun.
Freedom is a song performed by Beyoncé and rapper Kendrick Lamar. During this song, they dive deep back into black history, dating all the way back to slavery. The message of freedom is clear, that we will overcome, and soon we will be free from racism and oppression all across the nation. Here to dance to the song is Deja, Shaquilla, Kiera, Kiori, Constance, and Tanya.
Thank you. I'm telling these tears, go and fall away, fall away, oh. May the last one burn into flame.
Tatiana Velasquez is a senior who attends Farmingdale High School. She was inspired to write a poem about the media narrative about Black history. Here is Tatiana reading her poem, What is History to You?
Black lives matter. How many hearts need to be shattered before we start a new chapter? Slavery was abolished, they printed it to the news, but the headlines I'm seeing show that is not true. Because people are still captive to their skin color, of which none of us can choose. So how much blood needs to be spewed before we get the news? Will Smith said, racism is not getting worse, it's just getting filmed. That's because this is not the first time a Black person has been killed. This has been happening over and over and over and over again. They say repetition is like the definition of insanity. So what does that say about our world? This world is broken. It needs to change. This has been happening since the beginning of age. So if I could take my skin off and leave it at the door, will people see color anymore? Will hearts be worth fighting for? Don't you think they want to be seen, heard from the voices underneath, waiting to be gleaned? So the question remains, as what you will do if the ball was passed to you.
movie Harriet is about Harriet Tubman. Born into slavery, Tubman escaped and subsequently made some 13 missions to rescue approximately 70 enslaved people, including family and friends, using the network of anti-slavery activists and safe houses known as the Underground Railroad. During the American Civil War, she served as an armed scout and spy for the Union Army. In her later years, Tubman was an activist in the movement for women's suffrage. The song has been described as a slow-burning, gospel-tinged ballad. It was noted that its chronicles themed of hope, overcoming obstacles, and kindness for others. The song's lyrics also make use of Tubman's last words before her death in 1913, "I go to prepare a place for you." Here to sing this powerful song and last song of the evening is Tanya Gomez.
Just my fail, but Lord knows I'll try.
All right, can we give all the student performers another round of applause, guys? Everybody take a bow.
Administration, staff, teachers, students, children, everybody that took the time out of their day to come here and be a part of what we're doing.
That wasn't supposed to happen. But we hope everyone enjoyed the show and will reflect upon our messages here tonight. Black history is American history, and Black joy is human history. Thank you.